Greetings, everybody. It's the Doctor, and it's time to do another featured episode mission for Season 10, The Iconian War. We did Blood of Ancients in the last one, and now it is time to do the next one on the list, which is Delta Flight. Captain Tom Paris has requested your help for a joint mission with his task force, Delta Flight. Report to the Sol System for your mission briefing. Again, I am doing this on my tactical character, the War Doctor. So he is geared up with an escort and really, really good ground abilities. So we'll see what this is going to involve, although it sounds like it may be a lot of space here, but let's find out.
Captain Tom Paris has requested your ship for a joint mission with his task force. I won't lie to you. We're not making much headway against the Iconians so far. You and your crew have proven to be capable of fighting them. Delta Flight is one of the only other teams to do so. Together, perhaps you can start to turn the tide. Report to the Cal Bryden system. Captain Paris and his team are waiting for you there.
Cal Bryden, a new system I've never heard of before. Rendezvous with Captain Tom Paris in the Cal Bryden system, which is located in the Beta Quadrant. You will get specialization qualification pilot, dilithium ore, and a console choice here. We'll look at those a bit later after we finish the mission here. Okay, let's do this. Where do I go? Again, with these cryptic where do you go things here. After you, all it says is Delta Flight. That is very nondescript. I guess I need to actually just go beam out. Go to the Cal Bryden system. Beta Quadrant. Here we go. Delta Flight, the recruit. Go to USS Burn. Of course, it doesn't tell you where the Burn is. It's not in Seoul. We just need to go to the system itself. Normally it would say go to the system and then go to blah blah blah. Being really weird. I think they could have some clearer where to go messages here. Cal Bryden. Where would Cal Bryden be? See, I've got no idea. I guess it's where this yellow circle is. Cal Bryden! That's close to Borg territory in the Beta Quadrant. Or in Borg territory. Yeah, it is. Well, that's interesting. Okay, let's see if we can get there a little faster. That's far away. That is very far away, actually. I still seem to be having some zooming problems with sector space. They said that that was supposed to be fixed on Tribble, but I don't think ultimately they fixed the zooming in problems, because I'll come to sector space and like you just saw, I was zoomed all the way out, but yet when I fly into the Sol system or something, my ship is like zoomed all the way in. They've got some zooming issues between star systems and sector space that I think they still need to fix. Also, I kind of think the scaling is maybe a bit off for the astrometrics view here. Just seems a bit larger in scale than maybe it should be. I'm not sure. I like the new star systems they have in sector space, but like you come to borders and stuff like this, it just looks too large to me. I don't know. It's weird. Of course, you could just turn that off and now you're really in space. And we'll get there eventually. Go to USS Burn. So this is kind of cool though that now we can fly all the way to the systems we need without having to cross borders or load new sectors in. Already now we're in, I guess where Gamma Orionis used to be or still is, or I don't know. But yeah, this is the Borg territory. Used to be Gamma Orionis. We're way up here. Here we go. I'm interested to see what this mission's about. Alright, and begin Delta flights. And there we go. Looks like a command ship. You are cleared for transport at your convenience. Great. Sir, we'll be monitoring the system for Herald patrols while you're in the briefing. The transporter room will be standing by to return you to the ship immediately if they enter sensor range. So that means that we're going to have Herald. So this is just the origin bridge. And this looks like Morel Paris. That's correct. So, interesting they brought her back for this, for these featured episodes, or at least this featured episode. Didn't think we would see her as part of the Iconian War, but here we go.
Welcome to the USS Byrne. Normally I'm the security chief and second officer on the USS Kirk, but she took heavy damage during the battle in the Lenas system. Until she gets out of dry dock, I and many of the crew accepted temporary postings to other ships. I wasn't expecting to get a request to join my father's task force, but Delta Flight is doing some good. I want to help.
All right.
We've both come a long way since the Regulus system, haven't we? I wasn't sure if I was getting out of that business with Bavat in one piece, but I'm sorry I haven't gotten the chance to thank you for your help until now. Thank you. Now back to the war. It's time to stop some Iconians.
It'll be good to work with you, or is it difficult working with your father? Ooh, let's get some backstory here.
It's not that unusual. My grandfather was an admiral, and my mom, and most of the people I consider my extended family are either in Starfleet or are like Seven, who might as well be. Truthfully, I think Dad's finding this more difficult than I am.
All right, it'll be good to work with you.
I'm looking forward to it, too. I don't know what crazy scheme my father's cooked up this time, but the more off the wall his ideas are, the more they seem to work. With you on the team, I'm sure we'll complete this mission. But let me know if you need me to translate. Dad has this habit of talking in phrases that went out of style 400 years ago.
Well, I'm sure we can understand them because we are that period of time. That would be 400 years ago. Is this him? You know, I've been kind of thinking about the his appearance here, and we saw it in the last mission. Not quite sure that it really looks like him. I mean, yeah, I guess he's supposed to be aged, sure. That would change anybody's look, but it just doesn't look like Tom Paris to me. I don't see Tom Paris in this rendering of him. I just don't. I mean, if they didn't have his name up here and you just brought me in front of this random person here, I wouldn't be able to recognize his face. I wouldn't be able to recognize who that was without the name. So, yeah. Also, the voice. I need to hear more of it, but from the last mission, really didn't sound like him. I know it's the same actor, but I guess maybe he just hasn't found his place yet in bringing back that character's particular voice. Anyway, let's get on with this. Speak with the members of the Delta Flight. Speak with Ensign Conogenus. Speak with Groth. Speak with Hayden Demora. Speak with Andrew Weston. And speak with Ferrix. Well, these are some crazy names. So we have just people to talk to, huh? Okay, well, let's just start back here. Who are you? Conogenus.
I'm Conogenus, the team scout. No one's better than I am at finding trouble. And believe me, I've found plenty. I borrowed my first shuttle off a landing pad when I was 10. I didn't think I'd ever have a chance to join Starfleet. But luckily, people like Captain Paris can see the person behind the incident reports. Now I have a chance to make a difference.
A Bajoran here.
It's good to get a chance to know everyone on the team before the action starts. It's bad enough fighting the Herald. We don't need any interpersonal conflicts muddying the waters. You can count on me, sir, and I know I can count on you.
I like the fact that they are letting the Bajorans wear their jewelry and stuff on their ears. This was, of course, thanks to Ro Laren, who made sure Bajorans got to wear their things. Alright, who else do we have here? Let's see.
Jolan True, do you understand ancient Earth humor? Paris, the older one, keeps asking me if I am 2 weeks from retirement. Is that supposed to be humorous?
You do look a bit beat up there.
I thought so. Look, when things get messy out there, and they will, stick with the team and keep your head down. If we work together, we might just get out of this in one piece. Most of us, anyway.
Okay, and...
Hello there! I'm Ferrix, and I'm a... Well, I don't have a specialization like most of the others. But Captain Paris calls me the cook. I don't know why. I could burn water! But it seems to amuse him for some reason. I'm a trader and blockade runner. Any place where there's conflict, there's usually a few good deals to be made. I wasn't too sure about leaving the Delta Quadrant, knowing the territory is a good part of staying alive, you know. But Tom convinced me. And except for all the heralds trying to kill us, it's not too bad so far. You know, one of the things I've enjoyed the most about coming here is the opportunity to get to know people from other cultures. Klingons, Romulans, humans, Andorians, Betazoids. So many different and intriguing species. Say, after this mission, how about we grab a drink? And I can tell you about the third time I left Benth in custody and then broke through a Voth defense line to recover the lost chalice of Zilma.
Okay. Who are you?
Andrew Weston, all-around genius. Don't let the lack of pips on my collar fool you. I'm just as good as anyone from Starfleet. Better even, because I don't let the rules get in my way. I spent some time at the Academy, but I left when I realized Starfleet wasn't for me. We're all stayed. Always wondered if things would have been different for us if she'd had the courage to walk away when I did.
Slowly roll there, Captain Douchebag. Meral had her own path, it appears. Some of us find discipline and dedication important. Your service records indicates you were asked to leave the Academy?
Sure. Kirk reprograms the Kobayashi Maru, and he's a legend. I take a creative approach to alter my grade on the astrometrics final, and I get tossed out on my... ear.
Well, that's
Starfleet needs to
grade.
Loosen up a bit, if you ask me.
Wow.
And that time I spent in New Zealand? Yeah, I did everything they accused me of, and then I did my time. Like I said, I don't like rules.
Why are you here, then?
Just because I'm not as stiff doesn't mean I don't want to help win the war. My main focus is computers, specifically encryption algorithms. I've been studying the Iconian tech, and I think I've made some inroads into the fractals they're using for... You know what? The details don't matter. When it comes to taking out Iconian security protocols, I'm the man for the job.
Yeah, you keep your focus on the job. I'm gonna keep an eye on you, Weston. And, a Klingon.
Warrior! Join with us and stab at the heart of the Iconians. We will either be victorious or we race towards Stovacor. Today is a good day. I am the team's weapons expert. Most weapons on ships are too puny. I make them strong. Have you ever wondered what would happen if you loaded 5 quantum torpedoes into one casing? You have to reinforce the tubes, but the result is most satisfying.
I like this guy. This is my guy right here, Garoth. You are awesome. 5 quantum torpedoes in one casing. Give me some more of that creative thought.
Thanks for coming. Nice to see you again, especially after what happened at New Romulus and Lanus. As you well know, the war is not going too well. Delta Flight is one of the ways we're trying to change that. We're a cross-faction team picked for our abilities, not our politics. Now the Alliance needs us to handle an important mission. I hate putting your crew at risk too, but we're gonna need you on this one.
I do hear his voice now that I'm listening. It's coming back to me, but still not quite the same. But the face, man, that face.
I don't know. I just don't know.
Not much. We're just going to slip into a heavily guarded system that the Iconians already control, avoid detection and probable destruction, steal a Solene device that could give them a beachhead in our dimension, and escape with our lives. Sound like fun?
Yeah, let's do this. I'm ready.
So this used to be Calbriden 3. Intelligence believes that the Iconians destroyed the planet to gather materials for a subspace disruption device. We think they intend to use this device to open a door for their Solene forces to enter our space.
A whole new fleet for the Iconians? We can't let that happen.
Exactly. But the planetary debris has created an asteroid field, and the mineral content of those asteroids will shield us from the Iconian sensor arrays. I've plotted a course for us, but we'll still need to watch for the Herald patrols. The station with the device is in the center of the debris. Weston will override their computers while we run interference. Once the station's shields are down, we'll eliminate it and the device with extreme prejudice.
Is that another reference from that ancient program about impossible missions you like to watch?
Something like that. The Alliance doesn't have a fleet to send against this station. We're it. If we can't do it, no one can.
So, no pressure.
I hope you're all ready to do the best flying you've ever done, because that's what we're going to need to complete this mission. Let's head them up and move them out. Dismissed.
Okay. Standing by. Let's do this. Nice warp out there.
The rubble in our way used to be the planet known as Calbriden 3, uninhabited, luckily, but they had high amounts of topoline, uridium, and boronite. When the boronite and uridium are combined and exposed to an electrical charge, they create spatially inverted tetrions. Lots of spatially inverted tetrions.
Sure.
That's why the Heralds are here. To create a pocket of our space where the Solene can survive. From there, they'll expand, and what's good for the Solene is fairly terrible for us.
I forgot, the Solene cannot live in the same environment as us, and we can't live in the same environment as them. They are tetrion-based life forms. Alright, sounds like we arrived in the next
time. The Heralds have set up a security beacon at the entrance to this system. We'll need to disable it before we can attempt to slip through this asteroid field.
Fly to security perimeter satellite, setting a course for the security perimeter satellite. And I can cloak, so I'm going to do that. Y'all just stand back there. Look at that. All right, so that's what everybody's flying. I just want to see what everybody's flying here. These ships are weird. What are these ships? They're Federation ships, but I'm not familiar with what type of ship that is. And then what is this ship? I just want to see what everyone's flying. This is, of course, a Romulan ship. That's nice. I don't know what type, but it looks pretty cool. The Burn is a... looks like a command ship. And the Klingon ship. Cool. Alright. I was just curious. Fly to security perimeter satellite. Can do. Alright, I'm here. It's got a shield bubble around it.
Okay, Weston. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to take down this security grid. We only have a limited amount of time before a patrol comes by and finds us.
Okay, Mission Impossible reference there, Tom.
I need help inputting the proper subspace frequencies as I use my deflector dish to cycle through the possibilities. You'll need to match the alpha, beta, and gamma bands. With my subroutine scrambler, that should be enough to break through their security.
I'm not a scientist. I'm a tactical officer. I just want to shoot things. But it's making me be one. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Click it when it turns green. Green. I'm just guessing here, but I guess that's working. Green. Locked.
We've done it! Hurry! The security perimeter won't stay down for...
Okay, here's the good news. The topoline and the planetary debris will hide us from the Herald sensors. Now keep the larger deposits between your ship and the Iconian station. If you stray too far off the path, they'll find us. So keep moving and stay in formation.
If you encounter any patrols, take them out as quickly as you can. We need to get in position before the heralds know we're here.
Follow the path through the planetary debris. Keep moving and avoid or destroy the
heralds. How would
you
rate your piloting abilities?
Ooh, we get to make a choice here. This is similar to some past missions where we've had a choice of easy, normal, or hard. Selecting a lower difficulty will allow you more time to reach checkpoints. I pilot my own shuttle sometimes, easy, or I'm a fairly average pilot, normal. Or my piloting skills may even rival your own. Well, now that may technically be true, but I've never played this mission before, so... let's go with the normal. We'll just go with the middle option here. I'll probably try hard on the Romulan or KDF playthrough after I at least play this through once and figure out how to do it.
Bringing up your navigational HUD now.
Fly information, follow planned course, so I will cloak again as well. I mean, that seems pretty easy so far.
Try to stick to the path I've outlined.
I think that's simple. Oh, you have a time limit to do it. But that's
the mineral content of the asteroids will shield us from the Herald sensors. Try to stay in formation with the rest of the squadron.
Oh, I have to try to stay in formation too? Oh, well, they're behind me.
Let's kick the tires and light the fires.
That's what I'm doing. Actually, this is not difficult at all.
I'm not sure what that means. Is it some kind of alpha quadrant thing?
Kinda.
That is weird.
I'll explain it later, Ferrix.
Took a
fire your proton packs, kids.
Weird turn.
Next turn is a tight one.
That was a tight turn. Didn't see that coming.
Easy enough for a talented, handsome pilot like myself.
It is getting a little more difficult.
Everyone's mom tells them they're handsome, Ferrix.
Friendly fire. Ow, I'm wounded.
Fewer asteroids through here. More chances of being spotted.
Race you.
Torpedoes.
We're in luck.
Loaded and
sensors
ready.
Show that this asteroid is mostly hollow. If we blow through where the rock is thinnest, we can slip through without being detected.
Okay, do it.
Fire in the hole.
Would that get some attention, though? Wouldn't they, like, see that explosion? Guess not. Where am I supposed to be going now? Because my rings disappeared.
Let's get going. Stick close to the path on your HUD, or the heralds will pick up our energy signatures on their sensors. Ready?
Uh-oh. Okay. That wasn't too big of a deal.
Let's get going.
I had lost my my thingies, but they're way down here. Oh, I was supposed to go through the asteroid, and I went over the asteroid. I see where I messed up.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
Am I under attack again?
This reminds me of flying through Earth's space dock. They don't like it when you do that in full impulse.
Yeah. Wait. Who let Ferrix fly inside ESD? Weston?
No comment.
Fasten your seatbelts. It's gonna be a bumpy journey.
Alright, I see where I made my mistake. I was supposed to go through the asteroid all that time, and I didn't.
Oh, let's get going.
I'm ready. Go, engage. So I made a little mistake.
Ha! I've flown through worse in the Badlands.
Next time I'll do better.
Whoa, morale! Watch the paint job there, Tiger.
Don't be a rear-seat pilot.
I think you mean backseat driver.
But we're flying, sir.
I bet there's an accolade if you...
Herald Patrol, up ahead.
If you do
Take
this...
Take them out before they can warn the others.
If you do this without any missing any rings or combat or something... Oops, I missed that ring completely.
I'm jamming their outgoing transmissions, but it won't last.
Shields are down. We're taking on boarding parties.
Damn it! Hang on, Maral. I'm bringing a team over to help.
Take out those heralds.
Uh-oh. She needs help.
We need backup over here. Get it.
Now we get a little bit of ground mission in here. It's nice. Mix it up a little bit. Oh wait, what did that say? I went through the menu too fast. Oh well. Meet Tom Paris in Armory. Hi guys. Okay, I guess I can't fight them. Unseal armory device. Hi, guys. What are you hiding in here for?
Fell back here to grab some phaser rifles and got bottled up by those heralds. Thanks for the help. The bridge crew has sealed off the bridge and locked the ship's computers down, but the heralds aren't giving up. All of the remaining boarding parties are moving toward the bridge. If we don't get there before the heralds break through, they'll slaughter everyone there and set the ship to self-destruct. Now that you and your team are here, we can clear out the remaining heralds. Get to a turbo lift and head to the bridge. Lock and load, everybody. It's time to save the day.
Drop emergency force fields. Another way to the bridge, huh? I love the looks of these constructs. The powers and all was really cool. They're just not that difficult, but they look cool anyway. Take turbo left to bridge.
Maral!
Welcome to the party. We could use a little help.
Hey,
Well, that wasn't too bad. We did that really well. Let's pick this up over here.
I think that's the last of them. What's our status?
All other ships are secure.
Your ship is damaged and you have crew in sickbay, Morale. I don't want any unnecessary casualties. I have great respect for your abilities, but if this is some sort of Klingon, glory-seeking, never give up, today is a good day to die kind of thing...
Remain silent.
Everyone on this ship knew the risks when we started this mission, including me. The boarding parties are gone and we need to keep moving. We have to get to the station and finish our mission before we run into any more Herald patrols.
As much as I hate to say it, you're right. If we live through this, your mom is going to be so proud, but she's going to think I was an idiot for trying to hold you back. That's if we live. What do we need to do to get your ship back up and running?
I know a few of Andrew's tricks. Use one of his encrypted override codes to lock the Heralds out of our computer so they couldn't take control of the ship. I could use some extra hands to get these systems restored.
Good job on the computers, Morale, but... But Andrew? Did he teach you anything else that got him sent to a penal colony?
All right. Restore... I guess I have to do this. Restore power relays. Couldn't we just assign... Doffs to do this? Restore computer control.
That does it. Let's both get back to our ships and finish this.
And ready for transport.
The Heralds are going to notice one of their patrols is missing. Let's move.
I'm ready. This time, let's try to go through the rings.
Time to pick up the pace, people.
Hey, I'm at full impulses.
I got some scans of those ships.
Fast as the pace
goes. Should be an advantage when we get to the station.
We're coming up on the center of their operations.
I kind of like this mission. Pretty neat.
Detecting Solanae energy signatures ahead. They give me the creeps.
Wow, I've never seen anything like this.
Well, you have now. Well, I'm still cloaked. They can't see me, but they can see all my other ships. I guess I'm gonna have to get through
these. Target the ships defending the station.
Yep. You know, they're not that difficult. Those came down really easy.
Weston, you're up. We'll keep them busy.
On it.
Okay.
Iconian energy signature detected.
Evasive maneuvers. Pattern, Paris Delta 2.
Oh, okay.
Andrew!
Did Andrew just bite it?
We need
really?
To abort. We can't do this without Weston.
I can do it. Andrew gave me a backup copy of his algorithms in case something happened.
Did he die?
We're falling back.
Dad, I know you mean well, but I have to do this. You know what will happen if the Solanae can break through. We'll lose everything.
Okay, Morale. You can be almost as stubborn as your mother, but I know when I'm beat. All right, people, you heard her. We're going in hot. Cover Morale's ship so she can finish this. We are Delta Flight, and we will not be stopped.
Okay. Guess we won't. Assault on the station, attack the Herald Dreadnought. Ooh. This I am looking forward to. Ow, I'm being thrown all over the place. Oh, got me a solar thingy on me. What is it doing? It's changed colors.
Shields are down. It can be damaged. Four shields failing.
Oh, where did it go? Destroy shielding nodes, huh?
We're getting there. Attack the dreadnought.
Okay, good. We're doing pretty good damage to it.
Two nodes left on the station. Take them out now.
You got it.
Last node. Destroy it, and we can take out the dreadnought and finish this.
Working on it.
Shields are offline. Destroy the dreadnought.
Would love to. Where is it? Mr. Dreadnought, where are you? That and that and that and that. Here we go. That was simple. We did it.
I'm trying something, and it's not just to bring their shields up. I think they're activating the station. They're trying to bring the Solanae through. Give me just a... Got it! Core shield's down. Hit him now!
Hit him! Destroy!
Detecting a power surge!
I have their main computer.
Blow it
they're
up!
Still trying to start the conversion process, but their shields are completely
okay,
down.
Okay, let's blow up this thing and head home.
Everybody's talking on top of each other.
We're being pulled in! Evasive maneuvers!
Yee-haw!
I wanted to blow it up too. You left me out of the fun. I wanted to shoot a torpedo at it. Come on. That's it. We're done?
I found something interesting in the computer system before the station blew. It's coordinates for another sphere. And this one looks to be very strategically important. It might even be a secondary hub for the Iconian Gateway Network. I grabbed everything on it I can find. I'll transmit the files to Captain Cochran at Alliance Command. Maybe he can get a team together to investigate.
Well, it was fun working with you.
The station is destroyed, and we've completed our mission. But not without paying a price. Weston was a talented engineer and
barely
a damn fine
him.
Pilot. He may not have wanted to be in Starfleet, but there was a time I didn't think I was Starfleet material either. Sometimes rebels make the best officers. We know our duty. We just have our own way of getting it done.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. It's been a pleasure flying with you. Maybe we can do it again sometime before this thing ends. Consider yourself an honorary member of Delta Flight.
Thank you. Well, another short mission. What is it with these short missions here? This is the big Iconian War at our doorstep, season 10, quote, the Iconian War, and these missions are like 10 minutes long. If I didn't go through all the dialogue and I just clicked through the dialogue, I could probably have this mission finished in like 10 minutes. All right, well, let's look at what gear we get.
Losing Weston is regrettable, but we needed a victory today. Thanks to you. We have won. Defeating a Herald Dreadnought is a significant achievement.
Wasn't that
destroying
difficult?
Their station and keeping the Solanae locked in subspace is even more valuable. The number of ships and soldiers we have is finite. We cannot allow the Iconians to have a numerical advantage, as well as a technological one. I will examine the files Lieutenant Commander Paris managed to recover from the Herald computers. Perhaps a strike on this base she found will be our next move.
Okay, we get a specialization qualification pilot, so this allows you to train one of our bridge officers to in the new pilot specification, which allows us to train them in pilot powers. So that's good. I like that they give us one of these free ones just for playing this mission at free specialization. That'll help. That means that what they're getting us ready for are the pilot ships, which will be coming in the future, I'm sure. And now we will have a pilot bridge op. We can have a pilot bridge officer who can be trained in those pilot skills and utilize that pilot bridge officer seating. So that's very cool. I like that. Now we get two consoles here. I'm looking to see if they're part of a set. They're not part of any special sets. This looks to be just a regular neutronium console engineering alloy that you would get for kinetic and all energy damage. A little weird that they put this here. I guess what they're thinking is that people are going to need to tank up their ships a little bit for the Herald ships. So they're thinking maybe people would benefit from a neutronium alloy. Of course, if you're like me, I go beyond that and I use the fleet level enhanced neutronium alloy, which gives, of course, higher kinetic and all energy damage, but also adds another modifier to it. You get this in your dilithium mine for your fleet, of course. This one improves ship hit points, so my ship hit points are a little bit higher with this neutronium alloy. That, of course, in your dilithium mine on your fleet. So those fleet engineering consoles there for that is a little bit better than what this allows you to have. Although, of course, you can upgrade this to Mark 14. Okay, the next one, though, this one looks unique. This one looks like something I've never seen before. Polaric Modulator, which is going to give us plus 5 inertia, plus 12% flight speed. This is an engineering console, yes. 20% turn rate while in slipstream. Don't know how necessary that really is. Adds 7.5% of your weapon power to your engine power as bonus power, and a plus 20% flight speed turn rate. This could be a good console on an escort. Imagine an escort, which is already really maneuverable, but now you've got this extra inertia, you've got flight speed, more turn rate, and more engine power as well. This could be a really good console for movement here. I'm going to take this console. I'll play around with it. I got an escort here. We'll just take that. So instead of, from Paris with love. That's so cute. It's, wow. Oh, I am loved. I hope that's Morel Paris telling me that, not Tom Paris telling me that. Because otherwise I would not feel so loved. Yeah, so that's how I'm going to take it. That's from Morel Paris. She's telling me she loves me. I knew it all along. She loves me. So there you go. We've got our specialization qualification pilot. I can make one of my bridge officers a pilot officer as well for those ships coming. And this console here, which is just a standalone console, not part of a set or anything specific, but just an extra unique new console that has some really cool abilities on it. That could help you with making your ship more maneuverable, which makes sense in a mission like we just played. Maneuverability being very important there for that type of thing. So this would go really good on an escort. Of course, I guess it can make any ship fly, you know, more maneuverable, but on an escort that's already more maneuverable, you'll just be all over the place. It'll be fun. Okay, well, that's it, guys. That's Delta Flight. And actually, that's the end of the featured episodes for this Season 10, the Iconian War. Here's what I'm left with after playing these. I'm left with a feeling, number one, that they were really short. I think Blood of the Ancients was a little bit longer, but Delta Flight really felt short. Really short. I guess they have more planned. I'll just say it again. It just feels like, you know, for this type of big thing that they've been building up for 5 years, and then Season 10 is the start of the Iconian War, it just seems like that there would be more missions, more episodes, more, you know, featured episodes for this type of thing, and that maybe they would be longer and a little more epic than they currently are. Both of them kind of just leave the story hanging. It basically leaves the story to where, like, you know, we're never going to finish off the Iconians for a long time. It's just going to be this ongoing thing. We're going to be fighting the Heralds and Iconians and whatever for a very, very, very long time. This is going to be a long, drawn-out war. That's what this feels like. And that's what I feel like they've started here. This is a long, drawn-out war. But they've kind of started it off with two missions that, I don't know, just doesn't feel like it adds up to the epicness that the Iconian War has been building up to for 5 years. I mean, they got 5 years of hype on this thing, and I just don't think it quite feels that hype. Now, there is a difference, of course, in this game between such things as featured episode series, season updates, and expansions. In the past, they have done 5-episode story arcs called featured episode series. Sometimes they would have released those between seasons, but sometimes they have attached those to seasons and released those with seasons as well. So there is precedent for that. And I feel that they could have done that here as well. I feel like this is the kind of epic story where they could have gone back to their roots and done a 5-story arc featured episode, quote, series. I think that this definitely is worthy of that. And then they still could have built more on after that if they needed to. So I felt that I feel there's a little room here for improvement on that front. There could have been a little bit more. We've seen those 5 arc episode series work really well in the past. You have the Breen one that they did. They have the Romulan one they introduced. Then they had the whole thing on Drozana Station, and then going back into the past and all that with the Davidians. So those 5 episode story arcs that they released that were later integrated into the main storyline worked really well at the time. I think this could have been another opportunity to do it. That's all I'm saying. What else? I'm looking forward to trying out the gear. It's a shame that all the gear is not available in Blood of the Ancients yet. You're going to have to replay this mission on those dates when that gear is out so you can get that gear set. But I am interested in trying it in space. It sounds really cool. Delta Flight, there really is not a need to replay that one because all it has is that one console. So you get that. You can get that on first playthrough. But I think I will try the harder difficulty on Delta Flight and see if I can do it. I'm interested in that. What else? You know, it's really hard to wrap up this whole Iconian storyline yet because it's not wrapped up. I mean, this is just the beginning of it. And over time, we'll get more and more and more. I just wish that we had a little bit more at the onset of it than, you know, dragging it on throughout the year and all that. But we'll see what happens. I'm optimistic, and I want to see how it turns out. In the meantime, the only other thing to do after playing these 2 missions is to go do the STFs, of course. I've told you guys, there's the Brotherhood of the Sword, Gateway to Grethor, and the Herald Sphere. Grinding those STFs to get Iconian marks and data cores will allow you to level up in the Iconian reputation. Yeah, it's another grind, but that's the way it is. That's, you know, to be expected. Honestly, I didn't expect any different. So I'm going to start with the normal versions of these STFs, and I'll record a blind playthrough, meaning I'll play it, you know, record my first playthrough of them on holodeck, and I will start with the normal version because I don't know what I'm doing. And from there, after I learn it and do it many, many, many times on normal, then I will try advanced and record that, and then after advanced, maybe even an elite run. Won't that be fun? I've heard they're kind of buggy and that some of them are failing the STF simply because they're bugged out and it's causing them to fail the STF. So maybe there will be some patches needed before you can actually complete them on advanced or elite. Otherwise, some people have said they're a little disappointed in that there's not a new battle zone with the Iconian War, because with the Voth, you have, of course, the whole Voth battle zone there on that Dyson sphere. Romulans have some kind of battle zones. You got a whole new Romulus anyway, which is unique in itself. You've got other battle zones for other things, but the Iconians don't get a battle zone, which is a little strange. I would have thought that, if anything, the Iconians deserve some kind of battle zone, whether it be space or ground or whatever, but there's not that type of thing. All we have are the three SDFs here. So if people were expecting that, unfortunately, that's not a thing yet. So, you know, what can I say? It is what it is. Well, I'm going to play the STFs next. That is next on the list. And I am going to go back and play these featured episodes on the KDF and the Romulan as well. I'll do a recording of that also. I probably will not spend as much time in it, though. Now that I played it, I don't really need to go through the dialogue as much. I'll just see if there's any differences. But otherwise, I'll just play through them as quickly as I can and see what those differences are on those factions. But that'll give me another chance to play them and try the other difficulty mode and maybe not mess up where I messed up before. Okay, well, drop a line. Let me know what you think of these two featured episodes for Season 10, The Iconian War. Thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for the next one.